two major steps you need to go through to create a screen. The first one is to use Reach's BMP application to download any bitmaps you need to display for your design. The second step is to define display objects. When creating your first screen, you need to understand what bitmaps are needed. And in order to load those bitmaps into the device, you need the BMP load program. So I'm going to go over now and show you how to use BMP load with bitmaps. But before I do that, I want to show you some options that are helpful when loading bitmaps. The first one is the sort BMP files when added or loaded. That should be checked simply because it puts the file names in a known order, which will correspond to the internal storage of the bitmaps and their indices. Second option of interest is the enable bitmap compression. This simply reduces the size of the bitmap so that it uses less flash file space, enabling you to use more bitmaps. And then we've enabled high color because our firmware supports high color. So let's go and load the bitmaps. I go over to Add BMP, and you can see in the My Pictures directory, I have my first BMP file, which is my logo, an on button state, or up, it's called an up bitmap, and then a down for the off state. Now you can see they're in a particular order. I used numbers just so that they would be ordered. If you do click on any of these, you can also get selected information. If you look on the right under selected BMP information, this is real helpful if you have any question about the size or the colors or the bits per pixel. Any information is displayed in that window. So let's go ahead and store those. Okay, it looks like we are successful loading our bitmaps. Now we're ready to create the objects for the bitmaps that we've downloaded. So you can see on your screen the boot up screen for our SLCD series board. And the first thing I'd like to do is just show you how to clear that screen. So the screen can be cleared with the Z command. Now you can see it's blank. The next thing we want to do is bring up our background bitmap, which was Reach Technology logo. That can be done with the XI command. So XI space the bitmap index, which was 1, and the coordinates for 0 is X and for Y is 0. Now you should see the logo screen. Next thing we want to do is make the font a little bit bigger than the built-in. So we have a built-in font that is 24 pixels in size and it's called 24B. So we have to use the font command, which is F, and the alias name, which is 24B, B being for bold. The next thing we want to do is define the button. And this button is going to be a latching button with two states. One we're going to call on, which is the first state, and the second is off. So let's do that. That's the BD command. First parameter is the button index, which we're going to define as 0, And then our coordinates for where we want to place the button. I'm going to put it at 210, 100, which I computed based on the existing bitmaps for this particular button. The type is a type 2, which is latching. For the first state, we want to define the button text, which will be on. And the second state will be off. And the next set of parameters are the x and y coordinates, first for the 0 state and then for the 1 state. And those are entered as x and y. And I calculated those being at coordinates 20, 20 within that bitmap image. So those are the coordinates for state 0. Now for state 1. And the next two parameters is the bitmap index for state 0 and then state 1. So the first is bitmap 2 we want to display with state 0 and bitmap index 3 for state 1. So I think our command's ready to go. Let's send it. And now you can see the button. And let's hit that button and see if the button works. The button works, and you can see that it also returns the state. So we've created our first screen. As you can tell by now, it's quite simple to create your own screens with our development kit. There's no lengthy install process, no IDE to learn, and there's no development team to train. So start your touchscreen project now. And I want to thank you very much for viewing this tutorial.